Hello YouTube, Mikey Cow here, and this is video number 14 in my series on utilizing Blender as a video editor. Now, in the previous video, I showed you how to do a fade in and fade out. And I also introduced you to the page up and page down keys on your keyboard, which allow you to quickly and precisely set the end frame for your video project. Now, in today's video, I want to talk about three things, and that is I want to show you how to utilize a gamma cross transition, and I also want to show you how you can use your frame range and your playback button to repeatedly review a small frame range of your video, so when you make transition edits, you can actually see in real time how things change. And finally, I want to show you how you can crossfade your audio after you've done your video transition. So let's get started. The first thing we need to do is we need to make a cut, and let's select our audio strip and our video strip, and we're going to go to the strip menu, and we're going to do a soft cut. And it's important to remember that when you are going to use a strip for a transition, it's smart to use a soft cut rather than a hard cut because you can readjust the strip when you use a soft cut, and you can't readjust the strip if you have a hard cut. So let's take this video right here and audio and hit the G button. Let's move it up. And what you need to do is remember that whenever we're crossing a group of strips to do a transition, they need to actually physically share the same frames. So they have to cross. So as long as they're at least on one frame, this will work. So I'm just going to place it so that it is like that. And the same that was true for when we were doing the gamma cross of our color strip to our video strip in the previous video for doing our fade in, the same is true for doing a gamma cross from video strip to video strip. We just need to select them in the order that we want the transition to happen. So we want this strip to transition to this strip, so that means we select this strip first, hold our shift button down, and select this strip. And now we go to the add menu, and we go to effect strip, and we select gamma cross. And that gives us our gamma cross strip on channel 5. And let's just place the green line right in front of this. And let's hit play to see what a gamma cross looks like. There you go. Now let me show you guys something that's kind of cool, and that is you can actually set your frame range to repeat a small section over and over and over again, and you can make subtle changes in real time and see how those changes affect the video in the preview window. So we can set our frame range quickly by going down here and selecting the frame set end frame and set start frame options, but you'll notice that next to these there's a shortcut key, E and S. So we can set our start frame with the S button and the end frame with the E button. And the way you do that is you just select the spot you want to put your start frame, and we hover our mouse cursor over the timeline and hit S. And that sets our start frame here. And we select another area somewhere past this gamma strip. And we hover our mouse cursor over the timeline again and hit E. And now we have a short frame range that we can play back continuously. Now it will just play this back over and over and over again. And we can actually make some changes and see how they affect things. I think you guys get the idea. Now, the last thing that we want to do is we have crossed our video strips, but the audio hasn't been crossfaded. So we can actually crossfade our audio very easily by just clicking on the audio strips and going down to the strip menu, and there's an actual option that will automatically crossfade the audio strips for us. Just click crossfade sounds. And now when you play this back, what it will do is it will slowly lower the volume level of this strip and simultaneously slowly increase the volume of this strip. Now you probably won't be able to hear this, but I'll play it anyway. There you go, guys. That's it for today. I'll see you in the next video.